Now time for material reading and book reading. Okay, the amount of space occupied by a three-dimensional object is known as its volume. Volume is denoted by the formula volume is equal to surface area into height. The SI unit of volume is cubic meter or meter cube. Next, volume of regularly shaped objects. In this, as in the case of area, the volume of a regularly shaped object can also be determined using an appropriate formula. Table 1.4 gives the formula used to calculate the volume of the regularly shaped objects. Now, first one is cube. This is cube figure. Volume formula is side into side into side. So, totally three sides. So, a cube. Next, cuboid means their breadth, height and length. So, length into breadth into height, that is LBH. Next, sphere. Sphere means 4 by 3 pi into radius cube. Radius is denoted by the symbol R. So, R cube. So, 4 by 3 pi R cube. Next, cylinder. Next is what? Cylinder. Cylinder pi into radius square into height. So, pi R squared H. Is it clear? Next, problem 1.3. Find the volume of the following. Take pi is equal to 22 by 7. First, a cube whose side is 3 cm. Second one, a cylinder whose radius is 3 meter and height is 7 meter. By using above formula, we have to calculate these answers. Solution. Volume of cube, what is the formula? Side into side into side. So, side already given in 3 centimeters. So, 3 into 3 into 3, totally 27. 3 threes are 9, 9 threes are 27. So, 27 cubic centimeter or centimeter cube. Second one is volume of cylinder is equal to pi into radius square into height. So, pi value already we know 22 by 7. Radius is 3. So, 3 into 3. Height is 7. So, 7 get cancelled. So, 22 into 3 into 3. So, 198 meter cube or cubic meter. Is it clear? Next, volume of liquids. Liquids also occupy some space and hence they also have volume. But liquids do not possess any definite shape. So, the volume of a liquid cannot be determined as in the case of solids. When a liquid is poured into a container, it takes the shape and volume of the container. The volume of any liquid is equal to the space that it fills, and it can be measured using a measuring cylinder or measuring beaker. Then the maximum value of a liquid that a container can hold is known as the capacity of the container. A measuring container is graduated as shown in figure. Listen carefully. These are the measuring container. This is 100 ml measuring cylinder. This is 250 ml. This is 500 and finally 1000 ml, which means 1 liter. these are the measuring cylinder. Okay, next, the volume of a liquid is equal to the volume of space it fills in the container. This can be directly observed from readings marked in the measuring containers. If we notice the measuring cups given in figure carefully, we can observe that the readings are marked in the unit of ml. This actually represents millimeter. To understand this unit volume, let us first understand how much a liter means. Liter is the commonly used unit to measure the volume of liquids. We know that unit of volume is cubic centimeter if the dimension of the object are given in centimeter. The cubic centimeter is commonly known as cc. A volume of 1000 cc termed as 1 liter. 1 liter equal to 1000 cc or centimeter cube. 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. Is it clear? Next, volume of irregularly shaped object. There is no formula to determine the volume of irregularly shaped object. As in the case of area, for this object volume can be determined by using measuring cylinder and water. Next, one activity is there. Activity 3, take a measuring cylinder and pour some water into it. Do not fill the cylinder completely. Note down the volume of water from the readings of the measuring cylinder. Take it as V1. Now take a small stone. And tie it with a thread. Immerse the stone inside the water by holding a thread. This has to be done such that stone does not touch the walls of the measuring cylinder. Now the level of water will rise. Note down the volume of water and take it as V2. The volume of the stone is equal to the rise in the volume of water. Listen carefully. Volume of V2 minus V1. Listen carefully. First one is measuring cylinder, 30 ml water will poured into a stone by using thread. The amount of water is increased. In this lesson already we know measurement. In this measurement one important thing is physical quantity. This physical quantity is classified into two types. What are those? Fundamental quantities and derived quantities. Next, the fundamental quantities. Fundamental quantities corresponding their units are called fundamental units. Derived quantities corresponding their units are called derived units. Derived units, what are the derived units are there? Area, volume. Area means we have to calculate area of regular object, area of irregular object. Area of irregular object means we have to use graphical method. Volume means volume of regular object. Next, volume of liquids, volume of irregular objects. Volume of liquid means we have to measure two types, measuring cylinder and liter and its multiples. Volume of irregular object means we have to use Archimedes principle. Last one is density. Density means definition of density and its units we have to discuss in this class, and also density of different materials, relation between density, mass and volume. These are we have to discuss in this lesson, and also measurement of very long distance like astronomical unit and light year. We have to study from this lesson. Okay, is it clear? Now time for homework questions, which means material reading. What is one light year? What is one light year? One light year is defined as distance traveled by light in vacuum during the period of 1 year. One light year is equal to 9.46 into 10 power 15 meter. Okay, next one. Define one astronomical unit. What is one astronomical unit? One astronomical unit is defined as the average distance between the earth and the sun. Okay, the value is 1 AU means astronomical unit, 149.6 million kilometer. Is it clear? First question is one light year, second one is one astronomical unit. Next one is important detailed question. Describe graphical method to find area of an irregularly shaped place figure. Place the leaf on a graph sheet and draw the outline of the leaf with a pencil. Remove the leaf. We can see outline of the leaf on the graph sheet. Next. Now, count the number of holes square enclosed within the outline the leaf. Take it to be M. Next. Then count the number of squares that are more than half. Take it as N. Next, count the number of squares which are half of a whole square. Note it to be P. Next, finally count the number of squares that are less than half. It to be Q. So M equal to N equal to P equal to Q. Now, approximate area of the leaf can be calculated using the formula. Approximate area of the leaf is equal to M plus 3 by 4 N plus 1 by 2 P plus 1 by 4 Q square meter. So the area of leaf is equal to dash. Okay, is it clear? Okay, next one important higher order thinking question is there are three shapes A, B, C are shown. A, B, C as shown below. First one is sphere A, next sphere B, sphere C. Sphere A and B are made of the same material. Sphere C is made of different material. So sphere A and C have equal radii. The radius of sphere of B is half of that A. Density of A is double that of C. Now answer the following questions. Listen carefully. Find the ratio of masses of spheres A and B. Next, find the ratio of volumes of spheres A and B. First one is masses, second one is volumes. Next one is find the masses of A and C sphere. Okay, how we can calculate? Listen carefully. Mass of the sphere A, we have to let it at MA. Mass of the sphere B, we have to take MB. Ratio of the mass of sphere A and B is equal to MA is to MB. So M is equal to D into V. MA, A means A sphere. MA is equal to DA into VA. MB is equal to DB into VB. Density are same. Okay. Volume of the sphere, we have to use the formula. A is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. B also same formula, but r is half of the radius. No. So r by 2. Okay. Now D into 4 by 3 pi r cube into 4 by 3 r by 2 into pi r cube. So 4 by 3 pi r cube, which is how much ratio? 1 is to 8, that is 8 is to 1 ratio. This is 8 is to 1 ratio. Next, ratio of volumes of spheres A and B, VA and VB is 8:1. Next, ratio of masses of sphere A and C, MA is to MC, 2D into V is to D into V. So, 2D into, 2:1 is the final answer. Is it clear? Next, few numerical problems are there. First one is, a circular disc has radius 10 cm. Find the area of the disc in meter square. So, pi value we have to take it as 3.14. We also take it as 22/7. Okay, in this question we have to take 3.14. Okay, radius is 10 cm. We have to change it as in meter. So, 0.1 meter. Area of the circle is equal to pi r square. Pi value 3.14. R square means 0.1 into 0.1. We have to multiply these three things. We get answer 0.314 meter square. Okay. Next. The dimension of the school playground is 800 meter into 500 meter. Find the area of the ground. Area of the ground A is equal to L into B. Length into breadth. Okay. So, 800 into 500. So, what? 4 lakh meter square or square meter. And last one is there. Two spheres of same size are made from copper and ions respectively. Find the ratio between their masses. Density of copper 8900 kilogram per meter cube and iron is 7800 kilogram per meter cube. Mass equal to density into volume. Density of copper DC is equal to 8900 kilogram per meter cube. Next, density of iron is equal to 7800 kilogram meter cube. Volume of copper sphere is equal to volume of iron sphere. MC equal to MC equal to DC into V is to M1 equal to D1 into V1. So, MC equal to DC means 8900, which means density of copper into V is equal to M1 into D1 means density of iron 7800 into V. So, MC is to M1. So, what is the value? 8900 is 7800, which is 1.14:1. So, ratio between the copper and iron sphere is 1.14:1 ratio. Is it clear? Okay, students, that's it. Thank you.